Well, today I am going to be spring cleaning our two bedrooms in our about 1,000 square foot house. And I am collaborating with Hillary at Old World Home. She's been doing a spring cleaning series over on her channel every Friday this month. So go check out her videos after you have been inspired to clean from my videos here. And I do quite a lot here with rearranging as well in our master because we are expecting another little one in May, if you didn't know. And so we're going to be making this work for a newborn as well. So with two bedrooms, I'm gonna share with you some cleaning, homemaking inspiration. And I'm just gonna take you along with me as I do this over about a week's time, finding random times throughout the day to clean. So the first thing I like to do is start up high, and I started with dusting my ceilings and my ceiling fans. We have a ceiling fan in our master bedroom, and I had done this a couple months ago, and I share my whole house spring cleaning video. I'll put that in the cards here, and then also in the description box if you want to see areas to clean in your whole house. But I did that again just because they get dusty, and the blades get dusty. And then I cleaned off the light, and I just took a duster and cleaned the ceiling, and then I started cleaning the walls too. And I do share that as well in that whole house spring cleaning video, but again, why not dust it off if I'm going to be doing this room again? And then I did wash the walls in certain areas because I wanted to do some touch-up painting as well in our master bedroom where we moved the bed, or there was something hanging there that had scratched it, or a chair had rubbed in that certain area. So I just have white walls, and so it was super easy because I had an extra pint of paint that I had from our local hardware store to just touch up and make it look fresh and new. And touch ups are such a simple thing to do to make a space look clean and fresh for the spring season. So we did the dusting and the painting, and then I always do my blinds and curtains and windows during this time of year. I wash my curtains that I have in both of our rooms. I actually ended up swapping them because we used to have the ones in my daughter's room, and I just liked the more neutral color in our bedroom. So I swapped those out and put the fun ones in her room. And then I always wipe off our blinds because they get dusty, bugs, guts, and other things get on the blinds. So I made sure to wipe that down with a damp cloth. And I just like to use microfiber cloths when I clean those areas. And then it was time to get to the windows. Now we live on a dustier, dirtier road, and I love having the windows open this time of year. So I took some time to really dust off the sills and the wipe off the inside of the windows, outside of the windows. Earlier this month, I had actually cleaned all the windows on the exterior, and so that was done. Screens are tricky sometimes, so I did wipe the screens down a little bit. I don't know if in the winter you're actually supposed to take your screens off or not. I've heard that somewhere, so let me know if you do, because it would actually help keep our windows a lot cleaner, I've noticed, if we didn't have our screens on in the winter. But anyways, our sills just get so dirty, and especially my daughter's room, because her room faces the more dusty side of the road. And so I really tried to work on cleaning those out just so that when the windows are open, that dust and dirt doesn't come into the rooms. All right, then the next areas I like to do are wiping down the crib for my daughter and just washing each little like spindle area off with, again, a wet cloth, and I had some dish soap on it too, and wiping those down. Obviously changing out the sheet, which is like a weekly if not more occurrence anyways. And this would be a good time if you also have a mattress pad for your toddlers or kids to change those out as well and wash those. Mine is a hand wash one, so I had done that actually a couple weeks ago just because there was an incident in the crib, so I didn't do it this time, but I do recommend doing that if you haven't lately. And then just wiping down all the nitty-gritty areas in her crib. And then I moved to the dressers, in both of our rooms and just wash those off again because fingerprints get on them, dust buildup, other things happen to get on those areas, especially if you have a infant or a toddler, little splatterers or something can get on those. Changing tables or dressers, whatever you use. So just swipe those down as well, and I did that. Another area I did in my room for sure was organize and declutter some of my clothes. Now I didn't really touch my husband's clothes this time or my daughter's really because she's always changing size, so I just took out some of her smaller stuff and put in the size she is. But for mine, also being pregnant, like I said, I just tried to kind of move out some of the bigger, bulkier winter sweaters because it is transition season here in the Dakotas where we live. And so sometimes I still need longer sweaters, like today when we got 6 inches of snow, but then the next 5 days it'll be 65 degrees. So, you know, just have those transition pieces. And I really am trying to have a more minimal wardrobe, even with being pregnant, just because I really truly wear about the same things once a week throughout the week. But I organized and decluttered that just a little bit and tucked that back away. And then of course the floors and rugs, if you have those in rooms, definitely clean those out. I showed in my spring cleaning video and getting the nitty gritty areas to go shake out your rugs outside and air them out with fresh air, and I highly recommend that. Just getting that dust and dirt out of them by hitting them outside. And then with us rearranging our bed, I was able to really get the floors clean in our room where the bed had been. And that's just a place that you would be shocked at how much dust grows under there. And then under my daughter's crib and just kind of in the corners, wiping all the baseboards down, wiping the floors down, just those areas that sometimes get overlooked, and get that wiped up. Those are the main areas that I cleaned in our bedrooms for this spring cleaning season. And we still have more to do in our bedroom, like the headboard behind me, we listed on Facebook Marketplace, so that will be hopefully selling. We had to move the bed, as you can tell, in front of the window, just so that we have room for the bassinet on the other side, since I sleep on the other side. And our bedrooms are not large, as you could tell from the closet cleaning. We just have a very simple, small closet. Both bedrooms are the same exact size, the closets are the same exact size. So it's nothing grand, nothing fancy, but if you take care of your home and make it look welcoming and homey to you and love on your home, then I think you can really enjoy your spaces. So I hope this encouraged you to spring clean your bedrooms today. Definitely check out Hillary's channel, like I said, and thanks to her for collaborating with me on this video. Well, I hope you have a blessed and wonderful day, and I'll talk with you in my next thread.